Hi, I'm Dr. Radhika, consultant dermatologist, trichologist, and cosmetologist of Cutisrug Clinic, Malleshwaram, Bangalore. White spots on the skin, what are the causes and treatments? So, not all white spots are vitiligo that usually patient gets anxious and comes to us. It can be a various causes why a person can develop these white spots. So, the causes can be in the form of pityriasis alba. This is nothing but a dry, not very much white, somewhere hyperpigmented patches that we usually see on the face and neck. And this is quite common in children rather than in the adults. It can be in the form of any kind of vitamin deficiencies, or a person has any kind of dust allergy or a family history of asthma or wheezing. These pityriasis alba is quite common in them. So the second cause can be in the form of pityriasis versicolor, also called as the fungal infection. How the patient comes to us is multiple white or, you know, hyperpigmented patches that is usually seen on the neck, the back and the chest. So why are these produced? It is nothing but an infection due to Malassezia species. That's a fungal infection. And these are quite common in patients who sweat a lot, or it can come from a person to person due to the contagious. So how do we differentiate this pityriasis versicolor? So we do a test called as the stretch sign. When we try to stretch the skin, so we will be able to see a lot of flakes. That is nothing but a dandruff kind thing, which confirms the diagnosis of pityriasis versicolor. So the next cause can be in the form of a nevous. That is nothing but your nevous depigmentosus or nevous anemicus, which also looks something similar to the white patches of the vitiligo, but do not have the characteristics of a vitiligenous patches. And these are present almost always during your childhood. That is, it can be a congenital, or it can start developing anytime after 1 year of age. These kind of increases as you kind of grow and your skin expands. And the next one cause can be in the form of a contact leucoderma. That is, a person using a lot of harsh chemicals on the skin, it kind of damages your melanin production cells called as the melanocytes, and ultimately there is no melanin or the pigment production itself. So that's how a person can develop a depigmented or a hyperpigmented patches, the usual one being a rubber band or a rubber shoes, or it can be in the form of a bindi, the chemicals that has been used in the stickers. So these are the ones that can cause chemical leucoderma, or it can also be in the form of a plastic usage or a leather purses or bells. A person can develop this chemical leucoderma. So let me try to explain the last cause, which is all we are worried about. That is nothing but the vitiligo. Vitiligo is kind of an autoimmune disorder where the pigment producing cells, the melanocytes that is there in your skin, kind of reduces the pigment production. It can be in the form of a damage to the melanocytes, or the enzymes that is being required for the melanin production can be less. So these vitiligo can be in the form of a genetic disorder. That is, 6.8 to 35% of the times the person can have a family history of vitiligo. It need not be their immediate family members. It can be in the form of any relatives in the family. So the treatment of these white spots depends on the underlying cause. As we already told, if it is pityriasis alba, that means which is usually seen in children, it can be treated with a good amount of moisturizers, trying to treat them with good emollients, and also if there is any vitamin deficiencies, that has to be treated. Otherwise, the pityriasis alba can be recurrent at times. So the treatment for pityriasis versicolor or the fungal infection causing these white spots, usually we give or treat them with antifungals like Ketoconazole or luniconazole. So these treatment has to be used for quite some time, say maybe 1 or 2 months, until all these white spots reduces, and also to avoid as much sweating as possible and trying to change or have a healthy lifestyle, or trying to change your clothes whenever you are sweating a lot. So how do we treat these nevous depigmentosus or nevous anemicus? So there is absolutely no treatment as such. That is, there is no topical creams which kind of help in reducing or bringing back the pigmentation. It has to be treated surgically. That is, if it is a small, a surgical excision of the entire nevus can be done, or we can also do a camouflage technique. So the treatment for chemical leucoderma is in the form of, first, to avoid the contact of these chemicals, trying to not use these chemicals anytime in the future because it can cause a new vitiligenous or white patches on your skin anywhere else where the chemical comes in contact with your skin. So the next treatment is to apply a topical creams like tacrolimus or topical moderate potent steroids can be used to help in producing the melanin pigment back. Sometimes when there is no melanin pigment production or there is complete damage of the melanocytes, then it has to be treated how we usually treat the normal vitiligo. So coming to the treatment of vitiligo, first thing is to reduce your stress levels, as stress can again aggravate your autoimmune disorder and again aggravate your production of or the damage to the melanocytes. So first thing is to avoid the stress. The second thing is to start using topical creams like tacrolimus or pimecrolimus or moderate to strong potent steroids. When it is on the face, we usually give low potent steroids like desowen or hydrocortisone, or it can also be in the form of vitamin D3 analogs like calcipotriol. Sometimes when the body surface area is lot, we as dermatologists, we usually treat them with oral tablets called steroids to reduce your autoimmune levels. And also these days, the newer molecule is called as tofacitinib, which is a Janus kinase inhibitor and helps in damage, whatever the damage has happened to the melanocytes and to regain the pigmentation. So the other way it can be treated is in the form of a phototherapy, which can be either a narrowband phototherapy, which is given in the hospital premises or the clinic premises, or if a patch is very small, limited to one or two body surface areas, then it can be treated in the form of a handheld machines, or it can also be treated in the form of an excimer, light or laser therapy. So what should a person do when more than 90% of his body surface area is involved with the white patches? Then whatever the normal pigmented patches is there, we can make it look like a white patch. That is, we call it as universalizing the vitiligenous patches with the help of a chemical called as 20% monobenzyl ether of hydroquinone. So these creams are given to the patients where it universalizes the color so that there's no difference between the depigmented and hyperpigmented patches and there is a universal color to the patient.